A very warm good morning to all my dear students. Today we will be going to recapitulate what we have done in our lesson, and the name of the lesson was The Elephant's Nose. And we read the story in which we came to know about how the elephant got their trunks. No? And we read the story in such a manner, with the help of the pictures. I have shown you the pictures in our live class, and I told you how the story progressed when the elephant has a lot of questions in his mind, and then what happened when he was making the questions to his aunt ostrich, then to his uncle giraffe, and then finally he got an opportunity to meet with a bird, and how the bird made him to understand that if he want to get his answer, he should have to meet the crocodile. So she referred him to the Limpopo river, and there he went. So this is what we have studied in our whole story. Now I will be going to summarize the story in which you will be easily able to understand some of the main event which has taken place in the story, when the story started prolonging. So let's begin with the summary. I have a summary here, and in this summary you will be knowing about the whole story. So long ago, elephant did not have trunks. So this was something which was been thought in the mind of the author, and the author told about that how the elephant got its long nose, or we can say in the other word, trunk. They had normal noses, but the name of this small elephant is Jumbo. So you can be asked the question that name the what is the name of the Jumbo? What is the name of the small animal? Or the elephant, the baby elephant. So you can give the answer. The name of the baby elephant is Jumbo. So Jumbo. But Jumbo, a small baby elephant, changed this. Jumbo was full of curiosity. He was always asking questions. If you remembered, I gave you one word. A person who is having a lot of queries with them, that persons are termed as... in the class also, when I was dealing in the classroom, I told you the word, and one or two students make the question also. The word was satiable. Satiable means a person who has lot of questions, lot of queries, out of curiosity. Once we have the curiosity, we make multiple questions. So this Jumbo was full of curiosity, and out of curiosity he became a satiable boy, satiable elephant, an animal which has lot of questions with him. So he was always asking questions. Once he wanted to know what a crocodile has for his dinner, so he had a question in his mind. Every day he make a question, and we came to know that he made the question to the ostrich, and the question to the ostrich was that how the ostrich is having such type of feathers, and the ostrich, instead of giving a wonderful answer or the answer giving him the answer for his question, the ostrich hit the elephant with the claws. Then secondly, he went to the giraffe, and the time when he looked at the giraffe, he again had a question in his mind that how the giraffe is having spots in his body. So he made a question to giraffe that, uncle, how do you have this type of spots in your body? And then the giraffe, instead of giving the answer, giraffe also spanked him with his hoof is a kind of a hard covering of the foot. So he was hit by them, and then he started moving towards the other end of the jungle. There he met a bird, and the time when he met a bird, what happened? The bird gave him the answer that if you want to get your answers, best thing is that you go towards the riverside. And she named out the river. What is the name of the river, children? Yes, it is Limpopo River. So he wanted to know what the crocodile has for his dinner. So the bird told him that if he want his answer, he could find his answer at the Limpopo River, at the edge of the river. So Jumbo stepped on something that looked like a log of wood. So he started making his journey towards the river, and he walked for many, many days, and then at last he reached to the edge of the river. But the time when he reached there, what he found? He found that there is a big log near the edge of the river. So he had a curiosity. What is it? Is it really a log? Log is the trunk of the wood. So Jumbo stepped on something that looked like a log of the river. It winked one eye, and the time when he went closer to the to that particular thing which looked like a log, when he looked to went towards very close to it, he found that one of the eye started winking. So the time when the eye one of the eye winked, then this elephant had an idea that it is not a log, it is something else, and the creature at once said that he was the crocodile. And the time when he winked, the elephant was little bit in confusion that whether it is really a log or a creature or an animal. So at once the crocodile replied, and he said that I am the crocodile. And Jumbo asked him what he eat for the dinner, and the time when the crocodile gave the answer that I am the crocodile, Jumbo was very happy, because he was in search of the crocodile, because he want to get the answer of his question that what the crocodiles have for their dinner. So he made a question at once to the crocodile, and he asked the question that what do you have for the dinner. The crocodile asked Jumbo to come closer, and the time when he made the question, the crocodile also, he asked that okay, you come near to me and I will be going to tell you the answer, so you lend your ears. So what happened? The crocodile asked the Jumbo to come closer. He said that he would whisper in his ear. Whisper means to speak very softly, very, very softly, to speak something. So he said that I will be going to give the answer, but I will not tell the answer in a louder manner. I want to speak to you in a very soft manner. But when Jumbo went closer, the crocodile caught him by his little nose. As soon as he went nearer to the crocodile also opened his snout, and he caught the small little nose, and the size of the nose was just like a boot. No, we read in our live class. So these are some of the things, children, you have to remember, okay? Whatever I am telling you in the live classes, that can be in a form of question for your term 1 examination, okay? So let's proceed. So the crocodile caught the nose of the elephant, which was very small, like a small boot. Jumbo sat back and pulled, and Jumbo, now he analyzed, my God, my nose is in the mouth of the crocodile. So he started pulling him back. He managed to free himself, but his nose is stretched, and you can see in the picture as well how the nose was being stretched. No, small nose was being pulled, and then finally the nose become longer and longer, so long that he could swish it around, and so long, a swish means to move with a soft sweeping or brushing sound. So he started moving it, and the sound was there. So he wrapped his nose in a cool banana leaves. So finally, when he got the long nose and he was able to get rid of the mouth of the crocodile, he went with that long nose and swishing from one place to another, or the movement from here and there to and fro. Then finally he went nearby the banana tree, and what he did, he wrapped his nose with the banana leaf and waited for it to shrink. And he thought that if I will be going to wrap it, and once it will be cooled down, finally the nose will come back to its original position or original shape and size. But it did not shrink. So Jumbo went home swishing his trunk, and when he came to know that after waiting for so many hours, the length of the trunk was the same. So what he did, he thought that let me go back to home. So he started moving towards his home by swishing his trunk, making a soft sweeping sound, and he reached to home. Then, whenever he want to eat, he could pull fruits from the tree with his long trunk, and this is how he got benefited with it. That the time when he wanted to eat the fruit, previously he was unable to reach to the higher point, but here he could able to reach. He can, with the help of the long trunk, he pulled the fruit from the branches of the tree. When he reached home, his family asked him what he had done to his nose, and Jambu told him that when he asked the crocodile on the bank of the Limpopo River what he has for the dinner, he gave me this long nose to keep. And since then, the elephant had the long trunk. Okay, so beautiful story we have read with the help of the book. Then I gave you the pictorial explanation. And now today I have explained you with the help of the summary, the brief summary of the whole story. I hope you must have understood this particular lesson very well now, and you can easily able to solve the questions. Okay, now some of the exercises which I have given to you. I don't know how many of you have done it in the form of homework or not, but the questions were give the meaning of the words, and the first word was claw. Claw means a sharp carved part of the toe of an animal. Okay, then the second one was spanked. Spanked means a slap or a hit with an open hand. Then the third word is hoof. Hoof is a hard covering of the foot of the animal. Then the next word is curiosity. Curiosity is the desire to know or to learn about something new. Okay, the next word is shh. That means a command to be silent. Like your teacher, your mummy used to sometimes say, no, shh. That means you have to remain quiet. You don't have to produce any noise there. And the next last word is swish. Swish means a movement. To move with a soft sweeping or a brushing sound. Okay. So these are some of the typical difficult words which was given in the book. And today I have explained you the meaning as well. I will be sharing you the answers with you after the class in your Google Classroom. Okay. Now let us discuss what we have learned. The first question was, what would Jambu always do? What would Jambu always do? Jambu was very much curious and he always asked questions. Okay. This I will be going to share you. Why did Jambu go to the river Limpopo? So he went to the river Limpopo in order to find out what a crocodile eat for the dinner. Okay, and the next word is, what did Jambu wrap his nose in? So he wrapped his nose in cool banana leaves. Okay, and the last question was, who gave Jambu his new nose? Who gave the new nose to Jambu? A crocodile gave the nose to Jambu. Okay, so all these answers I will be going to share you in your Google Classroom. Okay, I hope you have understood the story very well, and write down the answers in your copy. And one more thing which I want to share is, many of you have not sent me the presentation. Now, because you are having your examination, that is unit test from today onwards, so all the best for your test first of all, and you don't have to submit your presentation now. If you have made the recording, well and good. Keep it with you, and once the test will be over, then you can send me in my personal WhatsApp number. Okay, so take care, and may God bless you. All the best for your unit test. Okay.